Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chonzong. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Tuesday, the 3rd of August. India's worst-hit Maharashtra state eases COVID curbs as infections abate. US offers refuse to more Afghans who aided Americans in new program. And locals upset as Pakistan imposes new coronavirus lockdown in major cities. And now for all the details. At the peak of a second wave of infections driven by the Delta variant of the virus in April and May, India's Maharashtra state imposed restrictions on movements. On Tuesday, the state eased COVID-19 restrictions in most districts, including the financial capital of Mumbai, after a steady decline in new cases. India saw a drastic decline in the daily number of COVID-19 cases and recorded 30,549 new infections on Tuesday.
India's industrial hub of Maharashtra state eased COVID-19 restrictions in most districts on Tuesday, including in the financial capital of Mumbai, after a steady decline in new cases. Shops, malls and parks were allowed to open for longer and offices were allowed to operate at full capacity. However, cinemas, schools and places of worship will remain closed, according to a state government notice issued late on Monday. Maharashtra has been the worst affected state in India's COVID outbreak, accounting for more than 6 million of the 31.7 million cases. Even as India's COVID situation has been under control, several states have witnessed a surge in coronavirus infections last week. Kerala has now become a national concern as the southern state has been reporting half of country's new COVID-19 cases for the past few days. The total caseload of active cases in Kerala stood at 165,322 on Tuesday. The high-level multidisciplinary central team on a visit to Kerala has asked the state to ramp up vaccination and complete the sero survey as soon as possible, reports suggest. Kerala is observing a complete lockdown during the weekends and 5 days of normal functioning. Meanwhile, in a bid to prevent a surge in COVID cases, neighbouring Karnataka and Tamil Nadu have made it compulsory for interstate commuters from Kerala to show RT-PCR negative certificate at the border check posts. India has been the second most hard-hit country in the world, with its 31.7 million coronavirus infections, trailing only the United States. The South Asian nation has had 425,195 deaths.
River Ganges flowed above the danger mark following incessant rainfall in India's eastern Patna city, raising worries of locals on Tuesday. Excessive monsoon rains this year have affected many parts of India, throwing normal life out of gear.
Locals in Patna in India's eastern Bihar state on Tuesday expressed worries as the Ganges River was flowing above the danger mark in the city following incessant rainfall over the past 3 days. The increased river water level posed a threat to the residents living near the banks as it partially submerged some of the most famous spots where people visit to offer prayers as the river is considered holy. Excessive monsoon rains this year have affected many parts of India, throwing normal life out of gear as civic administrations often fail to cope with the challenges posed by them.
परेशानी नहीं डर अब है कि जिस तरह से गंगा बढ़ रही है और नदियां बढ़ रही है उससे पटना को काफी खतरे महसूस हो रही है और इसी तरह बढ़ता रहा तो फिर संभलना मुश्किल है.
Meanwhile, hundreds of houses and trees got partially submerged in residential areas of Kanpur city in India's northern Uttar Pradesh state as the Pando River flowed over the danger mark. Seasonal monsoon rains from June to September deliver more than 70% of India's rainfall and are crucial for farmers, but also cause deaths and mass displacement across South Asia every year.
The U.S. State Department has announced a new refugee program for thousands of Afghans' allies who may be targets of Taliban violence for their ties to America. Secretary of State Antony Blinken announced plans to set up the Priority 2 refugee program, covering Afghans who work for U.S.-funded projects and for U.S.-based non-government bodies and media outlets. U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken on Monday announced a new refugee program for thousands of Afghan allies who may be the targets of Taliban violence for their ties to America. Blinken, speaking during a briefing, said the new refugee program poses significant diplomatic, logistical and bureaucratic challenges. Blinken announced plans to set up the Priority 2 refugee program, covering Afghans who worked for U.S.-funded projects and for U.S.-based non-government bodies and media outlets. Though he acknowledged the new program didn't cover everyone who helped. The Priority 2 program applies to Afghans who do not qualify for the Special Immigration Visa SIV program that covers interpreters and others who worked for the U.S. government and their families.
Afghans who worked with the United States or the International Security Assistance Force at some point since 2001 are facing acute fears of persecution or retribution that will likely grow as coalition forces leave the country. We have a special responsibility to these individuals. They stood with us. We will stand with them.
The announcement of the program comes as fighting surges in Afghanistan ahead of the formal completion of the U.S. troop withdrawal at the end of this month, with the Taliban pushing to capture key provincial capitals. Blinken also said reports that Taliban insurgents have committed atrocities are deeply disturbing and totally unacceptable. Last week, about 200 applicants for those visas and their family members flew into the U.S. at the start of an evacuation effort dubbed Operation Allies Refuge that could include as many as 50,000 people or more.
In news from Pakistan, amid a huge spike in COVID-19 cases in Pakistan, authorities have imposed an effective lockdown in major cities, including Karachi, Lahore and Islamabad, till the end of this month. However, locals have expressed anger, saying the move will affect their livelihoods.
After the rapid increase in the rate of coronavirus infections in Pakistan, authorities on Monday imposed an effective lockdown in major cities across the country, including the commercial hub of Karachi and other urban centers. Locals in Karachi, the capital of Sindh province, expressed they were upset over a partial lockdown that has been imposed in the city and asked the government to restart work with some relief so that they can earn their daily bread.
We are not affordable for this kind of lockdown. If the government tells me to put a vaccine, then I have put a vaccine. If the government tells me to put a mask, then I have put a mask. Now, today, if the government tells me to sit in the house, then this is for me a problem that how will my house run? How will my kitchen run? So, I have to go to my SOPs, I have to do my work, and I have to come back. जहाँ तक बात लॉकडाउन सही लगाया या गलत लगाया, मैं ये समझता हूँ कि नरमी होनी चाहिए, काम काज खुलने चाहिए।
The new restrictions will be applicable from August 3 to 31 in cities including Lahore, Rawalpindi, Islamabad, Multan, Peshawar, Karachi and Hyderabad. Earlier, the restrictions were eased in July, but it led to a spike in new cases. All public transport between cities has been halted. Private cars and taxis are limited to 2 people. Ongoing examinations at schools and universities have also been postponed until after lockdown. Pakistan's COVID-19 cases tally stood at 1,043,277 on Tuesday, with 23,529 deaths reported so far.
Moving on, members of Pashtun community in Canada held anti-Pakistan protest in Toronto this past weekend, blaming Islamabad of sponsoring terrorism and fighting a proxy war in Afghanistan by funding the Taliban. They urged the international community to impose sanctions on Pakistan for harboring and sponsoring terrorism.
Terrorism?
Members of the Pashtun community in Canada staged anti-Pakistan protests in Toronto City this past weekend, blaming Islamabad for fighting a proxy war in Afghanistan and funding the Taliban in its offensives. Hundreds of protesters gathered for two separate demonstrations organized by Pashtuns of Pakistani origin and the Canadian Afghan Council. The protesters urged the international community to put economic, political and military sanctions on Pakistan for creating, harboring and sponsoring terrorism in the region.
Afghanistan has been in a proxy war for the last 40 years. The only person behind all of this is Pakistan. Pakistan is funding their Talibans. They are waiting at the border to cross Afghanistan. It is not just a war for Afghanistan, it's a proxy war. We have lost millions of lives. People are dying every day and nobody is here right now to help us.
Security situation in Afghanistan has deteriorated since the US-led international troops announced withdrawal in April, and the Taliban has been capturing major territories and border crossings. According to the US and Afghan officials, Pakistan wields considerable influence with the Taliban, and the insurgents have sanctuaries in the country whose main military-run intelligence service gives them support. Pakistan, however, denies the allegation.
Moving on to news from Sri Lanka. The Sri Lankan government has lifted its three-month-long inter-provincial ban across the country as the coronavirus vaccination drive picks up pace in the country. The island nation has administered at least 12.09 million doses of COVID vaccines so far against the coronavirus disease.
As the coronavirus vaccination drive picks pace in the country, Sri Lanka on Sunday lifted its three-month-long inter-provincial travel ban. The travel permission as of now will only be extended to government employees on official duty. The government also allowed the resumption of public bus services from Sunday, while train services resumed from Monday. Overcrowding in the services will be strictly prohibited, officials said. This comes as President Gotabaya Rajapaksa last week ordered the resumption of full state services from Monday. In view of the widening vaccination drive, he cancelled circulars permitting work from home for government employees. Sri Lanka has administered at least 12.09 million doses of COVID vaccine so far. As of Tuesday, the island nation has 313,769 confirmed cases of COVID-19 with 4,572 deaths. The country has received over 13.8 million vaccines. In the latest, Sri Lanka under the global COVAX facility received 724,000 vaccine doses from Japan on Saturday.
An award-winning paper mache artist in India's Jammu and Kashmir has painted a masterpiece fabric painting depicting Srinagar city, reminding people of the beauty and changes that the city has witnessed over the years.
A papier-mâché artist based in Srinagar city of India's northern Jammu and Kashmir has painted the old map of Srinagar, reminding people of the beauty and changes that the city has witnessed over the years. Maqbool Jaan, a renowned artist from the Lal Bazar area, has been working for more than two decades to preserve different local art forms like fabric painting, papier-mâché and pottery. Using a 5x7 feet fabric, he tried to show the lost beauty of the ancient Srinagar, including the iconic Dal Lake, Jhelum River and other tourist attraction, to remind the young generation of the importance of preserving the culture and tradition of Kashmir and conserving the environment.
Jab tourist yahan aa jayega ye khareedega, jab tourist yahan nahi aa jayega aaj jaisa ka bekar hai yahan, jab market hi khatam ho jayega, yahi main yaad dila raha hu Kashmir jahilium kya tha, ye kya tha, isliye maine ye socha ye main banaunga naya sir unko yaad dilaunga.
Maqbool, who has won four national and one international award for his contributions towards art, hopes that this painting will be kept in the Parliament of India. The art of papier-mâché was highly favoured by Mughal emperors of the 15th and 16th centuries. The unique craft involves the use of papier pulp to create artifacts painted by expert craftsmen with lifelike images of kingfishers, maple leaves and other motifs.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/isasianewsline and follow us on Twitter at isasianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe TAG TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.